What a wonderful world. Welcome back again to MC Giri with Myra, and you're with me, your host Myra DeCosta, present here. Today is going to be a little different, but before that, I would like to thank everybody, a big thank you for all those who love Sanjam. Let me tell you that we have officially reached 1,000 views for Sanjam, and I'm very glad, and it's very positive for me because this is kind of an encouragement. So based on that, today I'm going to personally be looking forward towards emotion. So I've been asking people in terms of what they have been doing and what keeps them happy during this time of the pandemic.
Hi guys, I'm Stanvin D'Souza and I'm a financial advisor by profession. So what has made me the most happiest this quarantine is, you know, the course which I had taken, a 2 months course on stock exchange. Yeah, so I have been contributing towards it. So this has been beneficial not only for me, but to inculcate knowledge in the minds of all the people regarding financial markets. You know, when I have started trading myself on the stock exchange, it's a new challenge, and this has created a lot of, you know, portfolio building, you know, for myself.
My name is Merlin Lobo. I'm an accountant by profession, and what made me happy during this quarantine was going for fishing, also enjoying lovely, beautiful sunrises and sunsets.
Today we're going to be talking about something got to do with positivity. So first focusing on the circle of positivity. So today you're with me where I'll be making a crown, because positivity for me comes from craft, art and everything. So to make a crown, you'll be requiring is the flowers of your choice, also leaving up to you the leaves of what choices you want to add, and also the green tape along with golden wire and some Fevikwik or Fevicol. If you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe and also press the bell icon that is right over there to give you more notification of the videos coming your way. Okay, so this is how I make my circle of positivity or a crown. Then I have our very own golden things that we have crisscrossed and we have made into a thick wire. If you can see it clearly here. Alright, so we have made three wires combined together. Okay, so as I'm going along, I would like to also talk to you all about certain things. Well, first and foremost, I know that creativity or everything is only for certain people, and what I've noticed over the time is that many of our friend circle, you know, when they go for a job from 9 to 5, they were like, you know, I wish I could have done something different, I wish I could have done this and all. And looking forward with all the news coming in from the network about Corona and about all these people and many of us losing our jobs, and kind of very depressing situation, I must say. So I thought, why not maybe talk about them and tell you a few little stories that I have heard and that has motivated me to be positive. Alright, the first thing that I would like to tell is to be positive, you have to try and make sure that you are one of those people who are looking forward to change, if you can adapt to change. So my first story about change that motivated me is wherein I will tell you the story of two boys. One is John and one is Sean. Well, about John, if I can tell you, is John is a very rich boy who was a spoiled brat who got everything from his parents, whatever he wanted, right from childhood. And then we have another friend of ours whose name is Sean. Well, Sean was okay. He had to struggle in life. His parents were like, you know, middle class family where and he had to earn whatever he wanted, and he would not get whatever his, you know, whatever he wanted according to his need. Whereas for John, John was very rich. His family used to be into business. Both his parents are into business, so that kind of, you know, gave him everything whatever he wanted. So John, in spite of having everything, he was not happy. And above all, what made him really, really mad was that in spite of not having anything, Sean was happy. So as time passed by, John, you know, came to realization that he would never be happy in whatever he did. He had the latest vehicles, the cars, the latest phones and whatnot, but John would never be happy. Whereas Sean, in every small thing, he would be happy. Keeping the same, John decided, I'm not going to work hard, I'm going to leave myself being to whatever it is and my situation, and he remained the same. Time passed by, John remained on the same position, being unhappy with whatever he had, and he inherited whatever his family had for him, but yet still unhappy. Whereas Sean grew up from school to college, college to more. He grew up and he became a pilot, working very hard. Well, if you're telling and thinking why I am telling you this story is to make you understand that sometimes we need to adapt to changes, to change our mindset to be positive. If you are a person who is like John, then I feel really bad and sorry for you, because we need to work towards what we want to do in life and towards what we like to do. And if that means getting out of your comfort zone, you know, if you're not happy and if you're doing the things that make you unhappy, then I think we need to change our perspective and be ready for change. Similarly, in the situation of Corona, everything has changed. And what makes everything different this time is basically how that we have always been into the traditional side has completely taken away and gone forward to something different that we are not accustomed to. Well, that was one story about John and Sean and about how they decided to change upon their lives and what brought about it. The next one is a topic what I would like to talk about and tell you is the thing that motivated me is about hardship and struggles. Well, basically about hardship and struggle, I'll tell you the story that really inspired me was there was this one rich guy who had everything in the world. But what happened was every day he would complain to God and he would pray saying that, you know, God, take away this misery and the struggle. Why am I still struggling in spite of being rich? I have so many things. So much so that God once answered his prayer. He was very happy because God finally answered his prayers after his full lifetime that he had been praying. So God told him, pack up all your burdens that you have and your struggles and put it in a bag and bring it forward to the religious place and place it before me. So the guy does that. And once when he leaves his house, he noticed that he was not the only one and there were many other people walking forward with him towards the religious place. So as he continued walking, he noticed that the people had bigger bags as compared to him. And he was wondering as to why, you know, bigger bags, and it kind of made him hesitant because he saw his bag was quite smaller as compared to theirs. So he was hesitant, he didn't know what to do. And he went forward and once he reached to the religious place, he was a little scared, but he said, let's go forward and let's see what happens. Then all of a sudden, he heard a voice, everybody heard a voice was present there, saying, you can put forward all your burdens or your bags in front at the religious place. I want you all to place it down. And once when you place it down, you can take any bag which is around. But then by looking at the size of other people's, he kind of wondered what he should do. So he realized it was better to take his own bag back home. And out of fright and out of rush, as soon as everybody placed their bag down and started moving towards the bags, he went first and tried to capture his own bag. And he noticed that with him, there were everybody else who was coming to take away his bag. Well, in that hurry, he went running forward, took his own bag. But to his surprise, he saw that those people, instead of walking towards him, changed direction and moved forward in taking their own bags which they had bought. Well, the moral of this story is that life throws everything at us and what we need to do is accept it, because the struggles that we go through is the ones that are supposed to happen to us, because there is no one better than us who can go through those struggles. Well, everyone is chosen their own destiny, everyone is given forward, and this is why we mean that struggles that happen in our life, everything that happens in our life, instead of complaining about it, I think it's rather better to accept it, because we are the ones who are chosen The next thing that is very important in amidst all the struggle is to have your own belief and faith. There's another story that I think many of us have heard, is wherein there was a drought in a village, and many farmers were, you know, like kind of coming forward and praying to God to send heavy rain so that their fruits might flourish of all their hard work they had put in the field. So a time came where the people decided, let's come forward, meet up, and let's pray to God at a certain time. Every villager from that village agreed, and they met. Well, everybody in faith and belief, you know, came forward and said, let's come and let's pray. Let's try and ask God for help. So they all met up, they all prayed over whatever was happening, and they said, you know, God, just be with us and help us, and they are all praying. But then there was something that, you know, caught their eye. And it was a girl amongst all the people who had come over there to pray, who brought an umbrella, who had such deep faith that whatever is happening and whatever happens, she is going to pass it through, and she is going to be facing the rain soon. So this kind of took me away, because amongst all the people who were praying and wanted and had their faiths and beliefs, there was only one person who came forward with an umbrella expecting it to rain. So the moral of this story is, no matter how much that you've been facing, always believe in yourself and have faith in yourself that you can do many things in spite of whatever the struggle or difficulty is in this life. The last one and the most important quality that I feel that we require to have at this time to stay positive is never giving up. Okay, the last story that kind of motivated me was the very own donkey and the farmer. So once upon a time, there was a farmer who had a donkey, and his donkey once accidentally fell into the well. So the farmer tried his level best to take out the donkey from the well. And what happened after that was he tried all the things possible to take it out, but nothing worked. The donkey just kept on crying in midst of all the pain and everything. It just kept on crying. And then the farmer said, you know what, it's useless. The donkey is anyways old, so why just not leave it there? And the farmer left the donkey there, and he decided, the well is also old. I think it's better to bury the well along with the donkey inside, because there's no point getting them out. The donkey started wailing even more. He started crying even more. Later on, the farmer came back. He brought a few of the village friends of his that he had as neighbors to help him in closing the well. So once that happened, all other villagers gathered together trying to help the farmer in closing the well. The farmer, he used a shovel to throw the dirt from outside the well inside to bury it. And as he did that, the donkey started crying very loudly. The farmer felt bad, but he said, it's time to close the well. And he gave up. So the donkey started crying loudly, suddenly was quiet. The farmer threw the first dirt into the well, and to his surprise, he noticed what the donkey was doing. When he threw the first shovel of dirt inside, the donkey kind of shook the dirt off and took a step up. And then later, the donkey continuously, as the dirt was being thrown one after the other, he started taking a step on top. And to his surprise, by the end of all the throwing scenes, the donkey was finally coming up towards the brim of the well. Well, the moral of this story is that life is full of struggles, challenges, and yes, it is a lot of dirt and shovels being thrown by others. But giving up, that's not an option, because we have to work towards the betterment of what is coming forward. And ladies and gentlemen, with that, let me tell you that life is not going to be easy, but it's always important to stay positive, because once when you stay positive, everybody else around you is attracted to your positivity. It changes your mindset. So what we got to do is adapt to the changes, work towards with all the hardship and challenges in life, and then move on believing in yourself and having faith in yourself with no self-doubt. And then going forward on never giving up, because things will never work according to our plan. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how we work towards making the circle of positivity in our lives. And I hope that with this video, it has inspired many of us to work towards a betterment and also to work towards what we really want to achieve in life.
Through all the points that I have been telling and the stories, I hope they have been touching you all in different aspects of what you need in life right now. Well, the Cloud of Positivity is done for today, but please don't forget to stay tuned to next Tuesday where we'll be coming in with different aspects just for you. So till then, everybody, take care, be safe, and bye-bye for now.
And finally, this is what your positivity crown would look like.